Hi friends, welcome to PTU Melbourne. Today we are with a very reputable and very knowledgeable person, Natasha Lukin. She is a psychologist, scientist, an NLP coach, and a writer. Let's meet Natasha Lukin to know about her and her recent book, The Lukin Longevity System. So Natasha, welcome to PTU Melbourne and thanks for coming out. Please give us some information about yourself.
Oh, thank you very much for invitation to your channel. I really feel privileged to be on it. I'm Natasha Lukin. I am originally from Moscow, from Russia. I live in Australia for nearly 30 years.
Oh, wow.
So my background is as a scientist in biology, human biology, and then, you know, I've done many different things, always working related to human nature, human health, human well-being, lifestyle, and so on. So my book, you see this book, The Lukin Longevity System, it's a kind of summary of what I learned myself and what I want to give to people. Because it's not about me, it's about people. I know that it can be useful. The book is a little bit like a self-help book.
Wow.
A lot of real advice. You open the book, you can find advice.
Okay. So before we get into the book, I wanted to touch upon your background. I heard that you are a TV reporter and a production with the Moscow channel. You are very popular with the Good Evening Moscow show.
How do you know all of this?
And you also taught Russian language in Melbourne Uni, which is very reputable university. You have also done a bit of business in Canberra with your studio.
I'm surprised
studio.
You've been an investigation on me.
So give us a bit idea about you, you know, how your journey from a TV reporter to into this healthy, system is coming.
Okay, so a bit about me. I graduated from Moscow University as a scientist. I work a little bit as a scientist, but I had a very strong desire to share my knowledge, more educating people instead of doing science as such. So gradually I moved to start writing for the newspapers, but always on the topics of popular science, popular health, popular medicine, psychology, things like this. And then I did similar on television, Moscow television, the Moscow program, Good Evening Moscow. But it was always narrow to my specialization. I didn't write about ballet or I didn't write about something else. It always been medical, health, social, these things. Came to Australia in 1991. And I had a small position teaching Russian at Melbourne University.
Nice.
But when I came here, I realized I never mentioned I work on television actually because it wasn't relevant. You come to a new country, you cannot say, "Ah, look at me, I was working." Who cares?
Yeah.
So I learned new skills. I went to RMIT. I learned interpreting translation. I started working as interpreter translator. But again, I worked for Mercy Hospital, for doctors. Again, keeping in the same area. Then I worked for the Cancer Council of Victoria for 11 years as a health educator. And I wouldn't go into many details. Then I was in Canberra when I opened a small business based on remedial exercise and consultancy, helping people to get back in shape, not just physically, but emotionally and psychologically.
Wow. So Natasha, I believe the major idea about this book is about good nutrition, lifestyle and exercise. Is it correct?
Partly. It's correct partly. People have good nutrition, exercise, but they sit and wait when they die. Because they count the years, okay, today I'm 70, oh well, I don't know, and so on. You have to keep living much more than when you're young. When you're young, you live automatically, kind of. You don't think about it. You just live, you enjoy your life. When you're getting older, you need to do it consciously. That one of the things in my book, it's about conscious, about your brain and how you set up your mind. You talk to your mind. You talk to your mind like you talk to other people.
Wow.
Absolutely. You talk to your mind and you say, I want to enjoy my years. I want to meet new people. I want to live. I want to travel. I want to do something useful. That's very important to be like people need you. So what I'm saying, number one, curiosity, desire to live, interest to life. And then other things coming.
Wow, that's so enlightening and so informative. We are so happy to talk about this book and the research which you did. I'm very curious about one of the quote which is given in your book. It's called, age is just a number and aging is a condition of your mind and body. So I'm very curious, you know, how do you, how can you figure out, let's say, condition of people like me, you know, who may be looking very, you know, smiley and very healthy from outside, but we may have something going on in our mind and heart. So how do you, give us a bit of a practical side of, how do you manage those kind of issues?
Okay, every time it's a challenge because people are different. First impression very important. Even talking to you, you're talking about yourself. Your eyes express interest. It's very important. When people's eyes are dull, not showing interest, it put them down straight away like they're much older. Nice smile, open smile, interest in your eyes. Then a bit of a condition of your skin as well. Even your hair. So some outside things telling me a bit about your health and mental health as well, because it all goes all together. But the major part is conversation, because if someone wants to talk to me, they have a problem or they think they have a problem. And then when conversation starts, major difference now with any consultant, life coach or psychologist or whatever, it used to be like this. They tell you what to do. The psychologist used to tell you, you have to do this or you have to do this. Now it changed quite dramatically. Now I have to show you how to do
how
it.
How to do it. Okay. That's
very, a big difference, yeah, because knowledge now, everybody knows everything. Yes. Everybody on the internet. Nothing I can surprise you, tell you about stress or just depression. You read it, you heard about it. You don't need knowledge. You need to know how.
How? That's interesting. Is it all about aging or state of the mind or something more?
No, it's a lot more, of course. It's hard to express everything in short conversation. A very important thing which we use as a tool to help people called metaphor.
Wow.
So it's a story about someone else. A story should be quite interesting, exciting. Not telling you directly what to do, but show you how another people do it, how they manage their problems similar to yours. Because if you, I tell you directly, do this, you most likely think, no, I don't want to do it. But if you hear about someone else and see how it goes, you start getting it into your system.
Yeah. So that's a bit of like a storytelling and giving
storytelling,
some examples.
Absolutely.
Okay, that's
storytelling,
nice, that's
is a big part of a life coach.
So Natasha, tell us about the structure of this book. Is it a self-helping book?
In a way, yes. You can use it as a self-help mm-hmm. book mm-hmm. because actually, wherever you open the page, mm-hmm. I believe you see some advice.
Okay.
It's not like really A, B, C, D, mm-hmm. but a lot of practical advice.
One of the very interesting chapter in your book, Home Remedies, from where these home remedies are coming, it seems that you believe that some of the conditions can be healed by using herbs and homemade treatments.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. I came from the culture, I'm Russian, and home remedies is absolutely part of life for every family.
Same in India.
No, so it is for you to understand. Before going to the doctor, before taking medicine, even doctors supported in Russia, they support using alternative methods. We use simple things, water, hot water, cold water, soda, salt, iodine, herbs, plenty of herbs, roots, very similar probably, you know, and it works very well before you start using chemically created medicine. And also vodka, Russia and vodka, it's a good combination. Oh. I'm not saying drinking vodka, but vodka like in a little shots with pepper, for example. If you take it, you cure many conditions. If you start feeling cold or something, it's the first thing you can do. Nothing wrong about it. It's not to become a drunkard, you know. Yeah, so herbs, we use it outside as well on the body. Many Russian women use cucumbers to the face. Use a lot of steam rooms, maybe because of a colder climate. You know, in a steam room, we have a rye bread, soak it in the water, put it on the body. So a lot of connection to the natural product.
Oh, wow. Now we know the secrets of the beauty of Russian women. You know, they are very popular, you know, in the world. You know, they are
Russian skin,
skins,
yes.
Skins are really nice and good to know. And India is also doing quite well. You know, India has got all the modern infrastructure nowadays.
Of course, and Ayurveda, everybody
knows. Yeah, Ayurveda. And we have a very good combination of, you know, our old, you know, measures as well as the modern techniques. So I think it's going good.
Yeah, absolutely good. Yeah.
So Natasha, talking about Russia and Indian culture and the people, do you have some memories of some of the Bollywood heroes, Indian heroes, who've been very popular in Russia, I guess?
I know who you're talking about. You're talking about Raj Kapoor.
Wow.
Absolutely. I remember this movie with him from my nearly childhood. And was such a lovely movie, and I still remember this music from this movie. Mm. Yeah, and I love Bollywood movies because they bring you joy. It's so colorful, and they all singing, they all dancing, and it gives you joy. You know?
So Natasha, what will be your most important advice to the people, either in field of lifestyle, nutrition, or maybe in their relationships?
Best advice would be to live life consciously, with gusto, with curiosity, and make plans. Prioritize your values, prioritize your ideas and goals. And when you see the clear vision, what I want to say, vision is very important, vision of your future. When you have a vision, you know how to move there and find your ways. And then it includes lifestyle, relationship, every side of your life, but you need to do it consciously. That helps you to live happy and healthy life.
That was so interesting, so enlightening. And we were with Natasha Lukin today, the great writer. She has done so much good work in her life, and now she's in a mission to help others with her beautiful book, The Lukin Longevity System. We request all of our audience to buy this book from Amazon or Kindle.
Or from my website.
Or from her website.
I have a website, lukinlongevity.com, very easy. And we're just going to put it on a website to sell from website because it would be cheaper than on Amazon.
Yeah. So friends, thank you so much for watching PTV, and Natasha, thank you so much for talking to PTV Melbourne. We really appreciate it and look forward to meet you again.
Stay tuned for more exciting coverage.
Yay!
Thanks for watching.